Hi, we're back. I'm Hillary, and this is Courtney with WA Pilates, and we're here for, what is it, the second in our series that we just started. A little bit of work in the mat that you can do at home, and we're going to take that work today to the reformer. Last week it was the wonder chair. And we're going to again focus on the pelvic stability for Courtney. So we're going to start on the mat, and we're going to do a little bit of warming up with our abdominals. So Courtney's going to lie down on her back. Whew. Let's begin. All right, so let's just bring your legs into tabletop to start. Okay, so we're going to have the legs about hip width apart. And we're going to do some marching. And the focus here is we want to keep the back exactly as it is. Nice connection, rib cages connection. Rib cages connected, shoulders relaxed. And I want you to keep your leg shape exactly the same. It's like you have a little hinge at your hip. We're going to start with one leg. You're going to inhale as you lower towards the mat, only going where you can go, keeping everything in your torso as if it's stuck in cement. Exhale as you bring it back up. We'll stick with that leg. Inhale down, and exhale up. So she's just moving as if like a puppet with a leg that kind of moves around, nothing else. I like to say sometimes a Barbie doll. Mm-hmm. You can whip the leg around, but nothing else is moving. Two more. Good, exhaling. Trying to keep the shoulders relaxed. One more on that side. And now this leg is going to stay perfectly still, and the same thing on the other. And this may be completely different on this side. Does it feel different on this one? Let's see.
Yes.
Yes. And try to keep both sides of the waist lengthened. Don't let one hip hike up. Let's do two more on this side. One more. Now we're going to challenge even more. So keep the length on both sides of the waist, almost like scissors, but now your legs are bent. So you're going to inhale, take that first leg down, same way as it comes up. Other leg's going to go down. Good. Inhaling, exhaling. Good. And you're trying to keep weight even on each side of the hip. Back of the sacrum is on the mat, arms long. Feel those deep abdominals warming up?
Mm-hmm.
And we'll do one more, each leg. Good, and then bring both legs together. Now, if you can't go all the way to the floor, that's fine. When you get to the point where you feel as if your back's gonna lift up, then just place one foot at a time. But don't you try to squeeze the legs together. Keep that leg shape the same. Inhale, and we're gonna just lower both legs all the way to the mat. And rest the feet down. And we'll take them hip width apart. So, we're gonna go into some shoulder bridging. I'm gonna bring your feet in a little bit. And I want the feet to be straight right under the sit bones, knees towards the ceiling, and the pelvis is heavy. So the first thing I want you just to do a normal bridging with the pelvic tilt. We're gonna articulate as you roll up one vertebra at a time. Think your spine is like a little piece of tape and you're peeling it off. And I want you to feel like you're lengthening your knees away from your hips. Inhale at the top. And then exhale and you're rolling down one vertebra at a time. Scooping the belly. Pelvis going up to the ceiling. And then releasing the hips down. How's the back feel today?
Wonderful.
Okay. So again, that was good. Exhale as you tilt the pelvis, peeling the spine off. She's keeping the shoulders nice and relaxed. Sometimes you'll start to want to use that upper. Good. Nice diagonal line, and then slowly curl down. And what we're going to do now is we're going to add that marching into it. So with the marching added into this, we want you to really focus on keeping the stability in the pelvis and not letting one hip drop. We're going to do one leg, and then we'll come back down, and then we'll do the other leg. So you're going to curl it back up, really firing into the heels. Glutes are firing. So she's going to keep the hips really still. Whichever leg you want to start with, you're going to inhale and just bring it to the, yep, and then tap and back up. And keep lifting. Make sure this oblique is really firing on the side that leg is lifting and the glute is firing on the opposite. Let's just do one more. Keeping stable. Good. And then place the foot.
It's hard.
I know.
So this side may be completely different. Let's see. So tilt the pelvis, curling up. Feel like you're reaching your knees away. All right, you did good on the other side. So keep everything firing. Watch, this oblique needs to work. Yep. And then one side's always gonna be more challenging than the other. Firing into the upper back, firing into the triceps. Excuse me. Houston, allergies. One more. And bring the leg all the way down. Yes, and curling down. Good, releasing the hips at the bottom. And then go ahead and just pull the knees in, give it a little. How did that was good. You
it was.
I know, you've made some improvements.
Uh-oh.
Like, yay. Okay, so we're gonna do a little 100 prep. Let's keep both feet flat on the mat, knees together. So normally when we do hundreds, we curl up, arms are here, and we're gonna bring the arms down to your waist. What I want you to think about, bring your arms up towards the ceiling. You're only gonna curl up to the point where you can, like you normally would. Mm-hmm. And then don't lower the arms from there. The arms are gonna stay as if they're plugged into the shoulders. So wherever those shoulders are, those arms are with them. So you're only gonna curl up to that point and then back down, looking towards your knees. Mm-hmm. And then inhale as you go back down. And look wide and a little bit. Shoulder relax. Perfect. So think hundreds, you're curling up, you're pulling the abdominals into the back, keeping the back connected, and then back down. Mm-hmm. Do you feel a lot of the upper?
Yes, I do feel all of it, really.
Yeah, it gets everything. So exhale, squeezing the legs together. It's like someone's pulling your fingertips. Good, and down. So she gets pretty high. Some people may just be maybe the edge of the shoulder blade, maybe not. May just be a little bit of head and shoulder. Good. She's getting further and further each time. One more here, squeezing the legs together. Lovely, and then curl all the way down. And then bring the hands behind your head. All right, so we're gonna get into the lower, just a tad. Lengthen your legs straight up towards the ceiling. All right, so first I want you to externally rotate because of where we're going on the last one. Curl your head and shoulders up. We're gonna go into some leg lowers, double leg lowers, double leg stretch. So inhale as you reach the legs, only going where you can go, keeping that stability, exhale back up. Does not have to be a big movement. Inhale, exhale, don't go into my fingers. Inhale, exhale, and pointy fingers. One more. Oh, I should wait on my fingers. Now I want you to go down, hold, and I want little beats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and back up. Okay, so we're gonna work a little bit with our side legs. So we're just gonna do two kind of versions. So let's have you face this way. Head can be at either direction. Legs long. And let's have you a little bit angled there. And go ahead and take your shoulders, head. Okay. So Courtney is very flexible, like we said last week. So what we're going to do is externally rotate the top leg. So start dragging your heel a little bit, about halfway, and then stop. Okay, so what we want is the knee coming towards the ceiling. So she may have to roll a tad back to keep that going towards the ceiling, and that's fine. Some people may be, she's not very far back. Some people will be more. So the knee will be towards the ceiling the whole time. And again, dragging, continue. And you're gonna lengthen the leg up towards the ceiling, flex your foot, and reach like you're trying to touch the wall. And back to the other leg. So that's your move. Inhale as you bring it in, knee going towards the ceiling, lengthen up, flex your foot, and reach. We're trying to keep length throughout every side of the waist. And again, inhale.
Good, I like that length.
Uh-huh. It looks really nice, just long legs. Good, and flex, and down. Good. And for Courtney, she's just a little bit back on this bottom glute, but kind of for me, and most clients, it'd be a little further back. Now, Courtney, you're gonna reverse. So point, lengthen the leg up as high as you can without shortening any side there. Bend your elbow, bend your knee, and flex and press out that leg. Good, and then point and lift, inhale, and bend, and out. And make sure to pull the abs in. And one more. Yep. You're just like, which way was I going? Out, there you go. Let's do one more. Up, point, bend, flex, and press out. Now we're gonna stack back up. So hips are stacked. Go to parallel legs, both legs parallel. And let's take that top leg and just lift it about hip height there. Because it won't matter in a minute. Take it forward, just slightly forward, maybe a little there. Now hold. Internally rotate that leg. So, toes are towards the floor. I want you to dip down like there's a pool of water and lift back up. And down, and lift back up. And keeping it exactly where you started, like there's two walls right there. It's gonna wanna drift. So it's between two walls. You feeling this one?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Actually, this is one of my favorites. Two more. One more. Good. Now go back to parallel. Bring the legs slightly behind you. Mm-hmm. Externally rotate. And from there, so if you're just squeezing your glute to lower the heel a bit, and then lift, and lower, and lift. But don't let that pelvis tilt. Yeah. Do you feel that?
Yes, yeah. Thank you.
Two more. One more, and then bring that leg to the other leg, and rest. And we'll flip you, so you can face still this way, but other side. Okay, so each side's different. We'll see how this one goes. Okay, slightly forward. So we're putting the legs at a slight diagonal. You can have them straight out, a little more challenging. Okay. So externally rotate that top, and let's just halfway drag the heel, and then just roll back to where you need to have the knee towards the ceiling. Different on this side.
Yes.
Yes.
And look.
Uh-huh. So keep dragging, and then lengthen as you inhale up towards the ceiling. Flex your foot and press it down. Good. And then drag in as you inhale, shoulders relax. Does it feel more open in the hip on this side?
It feels different. I'm really unsure of why it feels different. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does. It just is. Yeah, you're definitely less back on that bottom glute than you are on the other side.
Oh, interesting.
Mm-hmm. Two more. Inhale. And reaching long. You can do 8 to 10 of these. One more. Good, and the bottom leg really active and long. Bring it all the way down and then reverse. So point as you go up, bend the knee, still going towards the ceiling, flex the foot as you press out. Good, and shoulders relax. That looks nice. Inhale, and reach. Try to make that top leg even longer. Lift, bending the knee. And one more here. Lengthen up. Flex. Oh, a little flex. It's like making you flex up there. And let's stack back up. Good. Right?
Yeah.
You ready for it? Lift that top leg. Take it slightly forward. Remember, there's two walls there.
Okay.
Toes dipping into the water and back up. And again, each leg may have different rotation. So you may feel like you're not dipping the toes in the same way. And that's fine. And this side you're doing very well. In the back, two, and one more. And then bring that leg up and behind you, just slightly externally rotate, and heel down and lift. Good. You don't want to go where it feels like awkward in the hip,
mm-hmm.
just to where you feel that little squeeze.
Okay.
Come back up. Because we have hips. We get in our way sometimes. Two more. One more. And then bring the legs together. Good. Roll onto your back. Pull the knees in and let's give it a little release. And then we're going to take all this that we kind of worked with and we're going to go to the reformers. Okay. So now we're on the reformer. We're going to make sure, let's check this out. Courtney is straight and grounded. And I'm going to put, what do you do for yours?
Four.
I'll put three red and a blue.
Mm-hmm.
Or four springs. Okay. So we're going to stay legs together. And I want you to think about when we did the mat work and the abdominals. And I want you to feel like when you push away into here, you're pushing from your core, from the low belly. Keep the arms long. I want you to press out as you inhale. Exhale, pull back in. And inhale out. And exhale, pull back in. And inhale out. Exhale back in. Good. And inhale out. Exhale in. Just keeping good connection with the whole leg into the foot. All the little toes have a home. Good. Keep that connection. Popping. Two more. Good. And one more. Good. Now, let's challenge the abs a little bit. Keep everything stable, and I want you to both legs at the same time. Stabilize. Lift the legs and lengthen them up. Flex your feet, and then we'll bend the knees and just place your arches together on the bar. Wrapping our foot around as best we can. Keeping that same connection. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Keep reaching your arms, controlling it all the way in. Mm-hmm. Good. Inhale out. Exhale. And really feel like you're pulling that carriage all the way in. Good. Perfect. Two more. Just warming up now. One more. Okay, now a little faster. Lengthen the legs up, flex your feet, heels on top, keep them connected, and press out. Inhale, exhale, keep reaching the arms long. Just keep it even on both sides of the waist. Good connection with the foot. Good. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Two more. One more. And then last one, lengthen the legs up. Externally rotate heels together, bend the knees, toes on, heels together, and press up, zipping up. And we're just going to do those three for her today. Good. Good. Knees are right at the shoulders, squeezing the inner thighs, wrapping around. Glute's got a bit of a warm-up over there.
Yes.
Two more. One more. Really pushing from the center. Good. And bring the legs together. Okay. So I lowered just a little bit your weight. And we're going to go ahead into our 100. I know. I can feel the excitement. Okay. So let's bend the knees all the way in. Elbows on the mat. Okay. So again, just like the foot bar is here. Against your feet. I want you to exhale as you curl up. Reach the arms. Reach the legs. Make little fists. And inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Try to curl it up. Lengthen. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Keep reaching. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, and Did you feel a little crooked?
I did.
I saw you got a hold of it though towards
the end.
Uh-huh. I was gonna say, and then right as I saw you kind of, what did it feel like wasn't?
It's that right oblique. It's not firing as hard.
Yeah. Yeah. But you were getting control of it.
I was trying.
It was working. Okay. So that's why we came out of it. All right. So let's go ahead and we're gonna tease her off.
Okay.
And then we're gonna turn you around this way. So we'll have this down. And let's have your legs long and sit towards the end, but where you're comfortable knowing that there's nothing back there.
Okay.
Okay. So, I'm gonna give you the handles on this one. So we're gonna finish up with some versions of rolling down here. And then we're gonna add, we did those side legs, so we're gonna add a little bit more, especially for Courtney, obliques. So I want you to go ahead and just have your arms as if you are on the Cadillac. So this is your roll bar, you're sitting on the Cadillac, and we're just gonna roll down, but I only want you rolling to the position where if you let go of the handles, your abs could hold you there.
Okay.
So looking towards your feet, wrists long, shoulders open. Feel the abs holding you, lower the arms a little bit, and you'll have them down there. And then exhale, curling back up, and then stacking back up. Good. So again, scooping the belly, rounding into my hand, like you're rounding down on the mat. Mm-hmm. One vertebra at a time. Hold there, and curl back up. And I want to feel like you're watching something go down that wall as you roll down. So you're looking towards your feet. Hold there, and then as you come up, you're watching that same, like a little ladybug going up the wall.
That's a good thing.
Yeah, I like a ladybug. One more this way. Good, shoulders relaxed. Everything good in the low back?
Oh yes.
Exhale as you curl back up. Good. And now we're gonna take this lovely one away. All right, so what I want you to do is take this hand behind your head.
Mm-hmm.
And I want you to take this leg and cross it over. Same move, but we're gonna hold it at the bottom. And we're gonna lift and lower this leg, keeping everything even as we go. So exhale as you curl back, and we're gonna watch that everything stays straight. Yeah, so just going where you can hold. Now think about that low belly and that oblique, and lengthen and lift that leg without anything moving, and down. We'll do four more, and three. And looking towards your foot. And then curling back up after that last one, just as you came down, curling up, one vertebra comes in, stacking it back up. One more time. How'd that feel?
Good. All right.
So everything stays stable. Reach the leg like you're trying to touch that wall. Good. She's doing really well, staying straight. Again, you're just doing the four. Ooh, that's okay. And then curling back up. Now I'm gonna change this and you can switch your legs. You're almost done. Okay, so everything straight, different side. Okay, so scooping the belly into my hand, curling back, taking that pelvis. Yes. And then,
ooh,
different side. Ready? Freeze frame. Two. Good. Relaxing the yes, there we go. Good. And again, we're just doing four. And then curling back up. Different side.
Very wobbly.
Okay. So you're straight. Curling down. Last one. Try to think about weight staying even. Really focusing on that low, low, low belly. Heavy, heavy leg here. Good. And if you can wind, oh, I know that's hard. And look more towards this direction. Good. And again, just the four. And back up. Uncross your legs and just reach for your feet. Give it a little stretch. How'd that feel?
Good.
Okay.
Challenging to keep my weight down,
but that was it. So, like we did last time, let's turn around and we'll both sit together.
Okay.
So, for the pelvic stability from what you took from the mat, like the side legs especially, I think, how did you feel that connection over here?
For the obliques. The obliques. It was hard to keep my right sit bone grounded because that's the weaker side, so it was hard to fire that when I was off balance to keep me on the mat equal. I was really, that was the hardest part. But I was channeling that sensation from the mat. I was trying to get back there.
But it was better, I think.
It got better every time.
Yeah, and with the hundreds, I felt like I was seeing a little favoring that one, and I was going to, and then I could see, okay, fire. I could see it in
you. I was trying.
Yeah, you were trying. So that was good.
It was good, thank you.
And how is the pelvic stability here compared to last week with the one to share? Because now, instead of being on that surface of the small, and we did some things on the floor.
This is a bit easier.
Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah. It's much easier to keep, because you have feedback.
Yes.
And you're supported.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not so much over at the window chair.
But next week, or when, maybe, hopefully next week, maybe the week after, we'll go to the Cadillac.
Yes.
Yes. Okay, thank you. That was good.